Well, welcome friends, let us go to the next task. That is, we have to show that congruent triangle cannot be constructed using SSA criteria. That is, when two sides are given and a non-included angle is given, we are not able to construct a congruent triangle. We have to construct an arbitrary triangle ABC, show that you cannot construct another triangle using SSA criteria where this angle A is not an included angle. Normally we use the tell the children that AS criteria, where that angle is an included angle. Let us see in GeoGebra. The steps are very simple. We are going to construct an arbitrary triangle. We will try to construct another triangle making use of two sides and a non-included angle now. Very simple. Let us go to the options. Let us see whether the labeling are new points only. It is there. Let us go to the polygon now. A, B, C and A. For one triangle is formed. Now for this, let us take two sides. Let me take this side AB. Let me check out what is its label. It is C. Let us see what is its label. It is A. Now remember, now this triangle can be moved and C and A changes. Now I want to take this side AB and BC and angle A which is not included. So let me check out what is the notation for that angle A. Let us fix it. It is now alpha. Therefore, I am going to make another triangle DEF where the length will be AB, another side will be BC and the angle will be alpha. For that, I am going to go for this segment with the given length, because I want the length of the one of the side of the new triangle should be equal to AB. Therefore, I am putting it over here. As AB is C now, I will type C over here. Okay. Now, I got a line segment of length DE. Remember, when I am moving this, DE also moves because that has been given a variable. Okay. Now, let us go for angle alpha, which is also a variable. Angle with a given size you have to take ED. Whenever it asks what is the angle, you have to put alpha here. That will be obtained from this list of symbols. Alpha, okay. Now alpha is made there. Let us make one arrow there or a ray. Let us make one ray there. Now this E can be changed by showing object. What is the advantage now? This AB is going on increasing. When I change it, then the angle also changes accordingly now. Now we have to locate the another point DEF to calculate, to construct the new triangle which may be congruent to this ABC. For that, we know what is the length of the third side or maybe the second side, that is small a. So let me take a circle with the center and radius. This is the center. What should be the radius? Radius should be equal to BC. But when I touch it, it asks you the radius. Let me type it as small a. Then I click it as OK. Oh, to our surprise, this is touching at two points now. Let us see the point of intersection now. This is the point of intersection number one. This is the point of intersection number two. OK. Now we know that both these lengths are of a. OK, when let us try to construct one triangle now, making use of these points now. Let me go for one triangle now, D, E, F and then D. I'm just going for one triangle now. Now let me remove this circle also. Let me remove this ray also. Now I got, I can remove this point G also. Let it be there. Now the thing is that now we have to check out whether these two triangles are congruent. For that, when I am moving it, all the points also is moving. Okay. Now let us try to check whether their corresponding parts are same. For that, let us try to find the remaining angles over here. Okay, well, now let us try to move these and then check it out whether both the triangles are congruent. Okay, I am moving over here. This is actually the one angle is coming as 104, another angle is coming here as 32 and here it is 43.2, here it is 43.2, but 61.09 and 75.01. Okay, therefore the two things which we have observed here is we are not getting a unique triangle which will be congruent to the given triangle. Therefore, we cannot construct congruent triangle using SSA criteria, that is using two sides and a non-included angle. Thank you.